Okay, so how can I tell that we got ripped off with Gran Turismo and that this isn't really the Gran Turismo 7 game they promised us that they spent those years and years building? How do I know? Because of the multitude of errors, just like a detective, okay? You know who gets away with murder? The guy without a motive. That's who. There's no motive. And so serial killers who just randomly kill people, there's no association and there's zero places for a detective to start. But if you give a detective the smallest amount of information, he can then grow upon that and develop more and more and more until he finally comes up with a motive. Now they can start looking at people, and it is a process, okay? It's exactly the same with Gran Turismo 7. Number one, okay? They had a license to have Pike's Peak in the game like they did with 3, A-Spec. Remember that? Pike's Peak was in the game. That's when they introduced us to the Escudo, remember? Well, all of the cars were running Gran Turismo stickers on their windows, but we didn't get Pike's Peak in this version of the game. Let's go back to the last race that I just did. Volkswagens, 80 horsepower, piece of fucking turd, and then GT3 car. They know you don't have a GT3 car. Why even put that in there with those? Why didn't you take that out? You see, because they were rushing. They didn't have time to fix that. You have a car that's called a RB 115. There's no manufacturer name. Completely fucking missing. Yet when you go to the menu, there's the name of the manufacturer. And it's just one thing after another in this game that tells me this was a quickly thrown together version, like a prologue, okay, until they could get enough PlayStation 5s manufactured. But they went, well, hey, what the fuck? We charged some of these people $100 for Gran Turismo 7, and we're giving them a fucking prologue game. How do we justify that? Well, we don't have to, because when they use our game, or when they use our PlayStation, we make them agree to a contract that would be illegal anywhere else, which says, yes, we are going to screw you. Yes, we are screwing you, but you cannot sue us. You must agree to our arbitration. You will bear all costs. You will bear all responsibilities, okay? So you can't sue us. So they had no fear. There was no fear of a fraudulent lawsuit being brought against them for giving us the wrong game. Now listen, I understand that COVID caused problems with all kinds of industries, okay? But when they realized that they were, if they came out with Gran Turismo 7 for PlayStation 5, that they were gonna only be able to sell a maximum of 5,000 fucking copies, they shit their pants. They shit their pants. Number one, they lied and said they had 10 million ready to ship. But when COVID hit, we realized they'd lied. And they realized that we realized they lied. Because people were selling those fucking things on eBay for $3,000. See? Motive. Not random. There's nothing random about me saying this is a fucking prologue version of the game we were supposed to get. And they have no fear. It's like the serial killer who says, okay, you can arrest me, but that's it. You can only arrest me. You can't put me in jail and you can't take me to trial. What is that guy's fucking motivation to stop killing? Just like what is PlayStation or Sony or Polyphony's reason to not continue to fuck us? Well, there isn't one. And they're going to lie, cheat, and steal all the way to the goddamn bank. And they figured out this is how they make money. This is not Gran Turismo 7. I don't give a fuck what they how they try to convince me, because there are too many great big giant pointy point arrows saying, oh, look here, look here, look here, look here, look here, look here. And the game is filled with them. But they had already pre-sold so many $100 copies of the fucking game that they had to come up with something, folks. They had to come up with something. And this abortion, Gran Turismo 7, was what they came up with. Okay? So this is not Gran Turismo 7. They lied. They cheated us. And what we got is a prologue version. I'll guarantee you, if you could sue Sony, they would be in court right now. I can tell you, I know there's at least 1,000 gamers just like me that would sue the fuck out of them. And they would lose big time because it's so obvious the crime that they perpetrated. And the motive they had to perpetrate that crime. It's all so obvious that I don't understand why more people don't really go, oh, well, why is the online shit being fixed once a week? Why are these fucking updates happening once a week? Why is 2 year fucking years later the online shit still so goddamn bad? Because this is not the game that we were supposed to buy that they worked many years on. This was something they worked 8 or 9 months on. And they kind of just took a little from here and a little from there, exactly like Prologue. So now when Gran Turismo 7 comes out, this is not 7. When Gran Turismo 7 comes out, they're going to say it can only be played on a PlayStation 5. Just like they said before they fucked us when they said this new version can only be played on a PlayStation 5. Then when they realized that they had to include PlayStation 4s or lose their asses, they just lied to us. That's all. Super simple. Just lie because they have no recourse. Gamers have no fucking recourse. And this is why I wanted to organize gamers into a financial powerhouse, because we would tell them, okay, well, you know what? You take this version of fucking Prologue and shove it up your goddamn ass. That's what you do. We're not buying it. Not only that, but if you're going to force us to sign a contract that says we can't take legal action against you when you deserve to have legal action taken against you, we're not going to buy your fucking consoles either. We're all going to go over to Xbox. And then you watch Xbox jump through fucking hoops to make sure that this doesn't happen to them. You see, there. What do you have? You got Xbox and PlayStation. That's it. Yeah, you got portable decks, Wii, whatever. Okay, but it's inconsequential. We understand. We know. PlayStation and Xbox. And they got together and said, we're not going to compete against one another. We're not going to say anything bad against one another. And we're both going to make them sign agreements that say you can't sue us because we are going to screw you over. We know we're going to screw you over because it is actually part of our business plan. But see, COVID exposed them because of this abortion that we have here has so many errors and mistakes that I haven't bothered to fix because they just didn't have time to fix them. They're still trying to make the online shit work. That was their big thing, right? With sport was, look, you can race online. That was their big fucking thing. And they made a big, giant shit about it online, in the movies, everything, all right? And so now, if they got busted, if they got caught, and they were forced to bring out paperwork, messaging, shit like they do in any criminal case, they'd be fucked. So being in the habit of screwing us, they had to do something, which is you can't sue us. Because we know we're going to get in legal trouble. You can't sue us.